Hello, my love, and welcome to this fear releasing and anxiety releasing yin yoga class. Hello from me and Priya. So if you've followed my yoga for a while, I do teach all different types of yoga, but yin yoga was actually my very first passion that basically got me into yoga. If you're unfamiliar with yin, basically, most of the yoga that you see in the West is vinyasa and has a lot to do with the physical, the muscles, working the muscles, maybe even how you look. You get that, you know, high that you get from after a workout, and there's nothing wrong with that at all, but it's very yang yoga. And what most of us need at this time on our planet is to do more yin, to sit more deeply with ourselves and to look inward, to heal on a deeper level than just the muscular system, because yang is focusing on the muscles, which is amazing. And I do teach this type of yoga. It's incredible. But yin can be so powerful. And often what doesn't really excite us in yoga, like, for example, sitting out a long time in a pose, the poses that feel most difficult and challenging for us are often what we need most. So yin, sitting for long periods in yin can feel difficult, even more challenging than you might expect, but that might just mean that it's exactly what your body needs. So yin yoga is working with the meridians. It's a Chinese system, so we're working with the meridians in the same way that acupuncture, acupressure, needling, and even EFT tapping, the same concept. So we have these meridians through our body, and in Chinese medicine, they're related to different emotions and different organs. So the same thing with putting a needle here in your back, it might help with your bladder, my stomach, but you know what I mean? It just helps with different parts of the body. Same with reflexology and, you know, different pressure points. So yin is the same concept, but rather than putting a needle in it or tapping it or putting pressure on these points, we're stretching them out. So in yin, we're holding the pose for a few minutes at least, whereas in vinyasa or more yang yoga, we're just holding them for a few breaths. In yin, we are holding it for average 2 to 6 or 7 minutes, and it's actually healing and hitting the deep connective tissue. So it is stretching a deeper level. This is great for healing on a physical level, mental, emotional, spiritual level. There's so many benefits. So please commit to making it to the end of this class with me. And if you're having any fears, we're always having fears come up. We're always having insecurities. And with our program, of course, there's fears. This is why I chose fear to be our first month on Sensual Body Love Yoga, because so many of you that have joined our first month together have written me and said that you have so much fear coming up with the lives. So I'd love you to join this class and setting the intention to be present for this whole class and to release any shame, fear, guilt around your body, around your beautiful temple body, your unique, incredible, miraculous temple body, and to feel safe in your body. So the very first thing I want to mention about fear is that we are all born with fear. It keeps us alive. Priya has so much fear because she is basically relying on me for her survival. And this is as you are as a child, as a baby. So we are born with the fear of falling, the fear of loud noises. When the alarm goes off here, Priya will be crying for hours after. It really scares her. And we have the fear of abandonment, which personally I have been healing my whole life and diving into deeper in my own experience because I was abandoned as a child. So that fear can really stay with you for a long time. And in this process, I've learned how to manage it and how to even love the fears that I have inside of me. And I really feel that the most important thing to begin is to really not try to push away our fear, but to accept it and love it as it is. And realize that aside from those three fears that we were born with, everything else has just been adopted from our environments. which means that we have the power to rewrite those stories of what we're scared of. Okay, so I have just grabbed my phone. If you see me looking at it, I have it on airplane mode and I have it for the timer. So beginning in a comfortable seated position, gently closing the eyes and just tuning into the breath, dropping from your day into your body now, perhaps moving the consciousness from the mind into the heart. Can you drop it into the heart space? Just for this next little time together, under an hour, can you be fully present as much as possible within the heart and within the body, giving yourself this time, gifting yourself this time to be fully present with yourself because you deserve it? Taking a deep breath in and completely filling up the lower belly, filling up the heart, expanding, and holding it at the top for a moment. And an audible exhale, releasing all tension. Releasing tension at the shoulders, maybe moving them a little, shaking. We'll do that two more times. Deep inhale in, completely filling up. Holding for a moment. Last one, deep inhale in, inhaling all the way into the hips, the lower belly. Expanding, expanding. Holding. We'll just begin some neck circles, focusing on releasing tension in your neck, in your shoulders, your traps, relaxing your face muscles, both directions. And releasing an audible exhale whenever feels good for you. Knowing that we can release all tension within the body through our exhales. Looking side to side. Taking this time to be gentle with yourself, with anything that comes up. Knowing it's all perfect. Knowing you are exactly where you are supposed to be. Nowhere to go. Nothing to do. Just being fully present with yourself and with me during this time together. Coming back to center. Feeling yourself in your body, scanning from head to toe, noticing any fears. Ask yourself, what do I fear at this time in my life? Maybe even, what is my greatest fear that is standing in the way from living the life of my wildest dreams, from completely loving myself, from stepping into my highest potential? Usually the first fear that comes up is what it is what your body is asking you to work with. So hold that fear within you for a moment. Allow yourself to experience it. Experience it without judgment, just as the loving, detached witness. Just witnessing. Where do you feel this fear or this insecurity or this feeling of anxiety? Where do you feel it within your body? Wherever it is, place your hand over the space and just breathe into it. Can you witness this feeling without any labels, without any judgments, without even trying to change it? Can you simply just witness it and let it be? Witness it in a way that you know it's not your reality. You weren't born with this innate fear. It was borrowed from your environment, from external factors. Know that it's okay, it's here. Maybe recognize it's just not serving your highest purpose, your highest good in this existence any longer. So now it's time to release, to let it go with love. Not because it's wrong, simply because it doesn't need to come into the next chapter with you. And maybe it still might be there, like I shared my fear of abandonment. Knowing that it might still be there in ways, but releasing it as much as we can with love, with acceptance, with gratitude for the lessons that we learned from it even. But knowing that it will no longer control our choices. Know that you are safe in your body. You are safe to live your greatness. You are safe to be all that you came here to be. Breathe that in for a moment. Filling up completely and holding at the top. We'll begin with butterfly pose. Can you leave your eyes closed if you'd like in these poses? I'm really keeping your awareness inward. So your feet are together, about 2 feet from your groin, wherever feels most comfortable for you. And taking an inhale in, sitting up nice and tall, and an audible exhale out. Falling forward as much as feels good for you. Wherever feels good, maybe you can go down. I do a little flutters to start because sometimes this, if I haven't done this pose in a while, it doesn't feel the best when I just jump right into it. So a little bit of flutters are okay. And then just holding. Honoring wherever you're at. I usually don't go very deep into this pose. It's not one that my body invites me to go deeper into, as many years as I've done this pose. So I just honor that. I release my ego and I just witness. So releasing your ego, yin yoga is not about how deeply you can go into a pose. It's just about healing and holding it as long as you can, finding your edge. So your edge is where it feels like you're getting a stretch, but not where it's hurting. And then doing your best to stay still in that space and just breathe. Breathe into the space that's being stretched. Inhaling love and light and healing. Exhaling your fears, insecurities, shame. Knowing that everyone on this planet holds fear, guilt, and shame within them. And that's okay. Doing our best, a little each day, to come back to our true essence, which is love, light, to our greatness that is our birthright. Maybe letting your head fall forward and just breathing. If at any point it starts to even hurt, you can come out of the pose a little bit. Doing your best to always stay still through these poses, as still as you can, but listening to your body if it wants to come out of the pose a little or to go a little bit deeper. Always listening and honoring. Your body always knows what it needs to heal. fully surrendering to this moment and breathing. Breathing in healing. Exhaling out all that is no longer serving you. Just witnessing, breathing into the belly, relaxing the belly, relaxing the face muscles, with your next inhale, sitting up tall, bring your hands behind your bottom, maybe little windshield wipers with the legs, just very slow. And holding to one side. You can hold just like this if it feels good, or coming down onto your elbows a little deeper. Just checking my time. And holding here. Remember, not pushing too much, just whatever your body is asking for, whatever feels good. Yin yoga is a lot of surrendering. Surrendering the ego, surrendering the mind, surrendering to the resistance, and just being. Being and breathing here. Few more deep breaths here. And gently switching sides and surrendering. Knowing that every side, each side, you only have two, knowing that each side is going to be different, and that's okay. One side will want to go a little deeper and one will have more resistance. So again, not pushing too much. It should never hurt your legs or your limbs, should never be going numb. It should feel good. It always feels good for me having this release. And yes, it gets difficult. Sometimes I just want to come out of the pose, but that's when I know that I need to lean into it a little bit. That's when I know that the healing is happening. Obviously, if it's not accompanied with pain, but you can feel that release. Ah. Sinking deeper into your healing, into this moment. Few more deep breaths here. With your next inhale, coming up onto the palms of the hands, taking your time to gently come out of this pose. Do a few more little windshield wipers, just very gently. Always releasing with the exhale. Inhaling new energy, new breath, new life. Exhaling the old. Next, we'll come into a wide-legged pose. You might even just want to stay here if it feels good. Sitting up tall. Big inhale in into the belly. And gently walking the hands out, fingers to whatever point feels good for you. You can use a block here too if it feels best. Now, for example, when I'm doing yang yoga, I will come right down. But in yin, I can bring my forehead straight to the ground. That's when I'm holding it for 30 seconds to a minute. In yin, I'm just staying on my elbows and honoring, maybe coming a little deeper when my body's asking for it. Relaxing the head down. Remembering to relax the belly, relax the face muscles, and just be present with yourself for the next few moments, present with the breath, present with the body. Now this one might get difficult, but just holding it, pushing through, knowing that we hold a lot of tension and memory and even trauma within our hips, really everywhere in our body, but our hips and our backs especially. So just surrendering, knowing if it's getting uncomfortable, that could just be uncomfortable emotions releasing. And if you feel anything, if you ever feel the need to cry, to laugh, really let your emotions be expressed fully. That's how they're released. With your next inhale, walking the fingertips gently back up. And with the eyes closed, just stretching side to side, allowing the breath to guide you. Knowing your body can heal and release anything you're ready to let go of, just through movement. Our bodies truly are miraculous. They can heal. We can heal ourselves. And coming back to center, bringing your legs together, melting heart pose. Now, if this is too hard for you, you can also sit like this, just bringing the hands behind you and opening up the heart. You can put blocks if you'd like, however deeply you can go. But if you're ready to come into a melted heart, the hips are staying above the knees and you're just slowly walking out as much as you can and bringing your forehead or your chin to the mat. And during this pose, just focusing on your connection to the earth below, even if you're like me and you're inside, feeling your connection to Gaia, to Mother Earth, knowing that you're held, knowing that you are always held, you're never alone, knowing that you are safe and nourished, you are safe in your own body. During this pose, we can repeat the internal mantra or affirmation. I am safe in my body. I surrender. I am safe in my body. I surrender. Repeating that internally. I am safe within my body. I surrender. 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 Breathing that in. Maybe melting down a little more to the earth below. With your next inhale, Just slowly coming back into child's pose, relaxing the hands down next to you, the arms are at your side, and breathing, your forehead is on the mat. And just allowing yourself like a child, like a baby, to be held by the earth below. Knowing you are safe here. Knowing that your fears may always exist, it's part of being human, but they no longer need to control the outcome of your life, your choices. You can witness as the detached, non-judgmental witness your fears, insecurities, your shadow, knowing that it is all perfect. It is just part of this game of life. Simply witness. That's all. Witness and know that it's not reality. With your next inhale, supporting yourself, coming up. And coming back onto your bottom. Again, you can use any blocks if you need, or you can even use blankets, pillows, if this is really difficult for you. If your body is asking for more support to hold your knees up more. So we are stacking ankle above knee, knee above ankle as best that we can. If this is too difficult, you can also just do one leg. If you can feel the stretch, again, always paying attention to that edge. And again, you can also place it up a little bit. So stacking and just breathing here. Feeling your connection to the earth below. If your body's welcoming you, coming forward a little, maybe relaxing the head down. If your body's asking you, coming in a little deeper. Deep inhale in, audible exhale, releasing. Make this one a really exaggerated exhale, really releasing all that you're ready to let go of. Deep inhale in. Even if it sounds weird, always letting it out. And with your next inhale, gently walking the fingers up, switching so the opposite foot, the opposite ankle is above the knee. This side isn't quite as flexible as the other for me, so I'm just honoring that, not pushing myself to go deeper into this. Next inhale, coming up. Bring the palms of the hands in, so your fingers are pointed towards your feet. Now the goal here is to keep the shoulders aligned with the wrists as much as you can, the best you can, and your knees above the ankles. So we're just simply pushing up, maybe the chin slightly tucked in, and pushing. So you're like making a table with your body. We're not gonna hold this for too long. So just breathing here. Not straining the neck too much, finding your comfortable, happy space. It's probably gonna feel awkward. Just breathing into it. Just about five more breaths here. Last breath and relaxing. Falling back into a happy baby pose, grabbing the outer edges of your feet. Maybe rocking your baby a little. Stretching out the legs if it feels good. Just playing in this pose a little. Releasing any leftover tension. Maybe doing some ankle circles. Not gonna lie, I love cracking my toes here. I don't know if it's the best thing, but it's like a nice release for me. And pushing down on your feet for a little deeper stretch. And just holding this pose for a moment. Gently bringing the legs together. Falling to one side, looking over the opposite shoulder. Remembering to relax the face muscles, relax the belly, just surrender into this pose. And then coming back to center, switching to the other side. Inhaling new energy. Exhale, coming a little deeper, relaxing a little more. With your next inhale, coming back to center, give yourself a big hug. Big thank you for making it through this practice. And relaxing to Shavasana. Corpse pose, just completely relaxing, allowing your body to melt into the mat, into the floor below. Honoring all that you've been through to get you to this point right now. All that your body has been through, all that your emotions have been through, all that you have overcome. Remembering your inner strength and knowing that you have the power to step through to the other side of your fears, the other side of your resistance, to take that leap, whatever it may be. Know that our fears are often our navigation systems, if you will, showing us where we need to go in order to live according to our greatness. Because what we're often scared of is where the most growth will take place. I do something that scares me pretty much every day. Can you do the same? Because I know what scares me is what I'm supposed to be doing. Because that is my ego frightened of change, of growth, of evolution. Our fears are sacred. Detaching from them and allowing them to guide you to your highest path, to your highest potential. Completely relaxing, completely surrendering. Moving your head back and forth a little bit, wiggling your toes, your fingers. When you're ready, just falling to the side for a moment, allowing yourself to be held. And in your own time, coming back up to a seated position, bring your hands in front of your heart. We'll close this practice together with one om. Taking a deep breath in. Shanti, shanti, shanti. When you're ready, blinking your eyes open or taking your time, staying here in meditation if you'd like. Thank you so much for joining this practice, for making it to the end. I love you deeply, and remember, your fears are sacred. There's nothing wrong with them, but they don't need to rule your life. You rule your life, no one else. You call the shots. Remember that. And for my YouTube friends who have tuned in and made it to the end of this practice, thank you. I love you. Subscribe for more. If you want to see more of my yoga videos, let me know. And also for more, you can come join. I'm inviting you to join our Sensual Body Love Yoga. You can find all the information at crystalaranyani.com/SBLY. Sensual Body Love Yoga, SBLY. I want to make sure I said that right. So I would love for you to join me there. It's actually clothing optional yoga. Obviously, I'm being appropriate for my YouTube at the moment, but everyone is welcome. It is clothing optional. It's a safe space and it's a community, a hub of self-love, body positivity, tantra, sacred sexuality, and so much more. I just launched it last month, so our library is continuously growing, our community is continuously growing, we have self-love challenges, a self-love book club, and a bunch of other stuff. So if you want to dive into self-love, if you want to do something that scares you and get naked on camera in front of a bunch of strangers, I've made it clothing optional, so it's not required, but definitely inviting you to try something new. Much love, you guys, and I'll see you in my next video.